I'm Dr. Bree from FemFusion Fitness, your home for core and pelvic floor friendly fitness and women's health information. And I have a Q&A for you today, which is a much requested topic. I have received this question in several different forms over the last, a couple years really. Many people have asked me, I have prolapse and I want to have another baby. Is this possible? And if it is possible, then what can I do to help prevent prolapse from getting worse or that kind of thing? So before I go any further with answering the question, I just want to make it very clear that everyone is different. Your level of prolapse and your level of healing may be very different from the next woman. So it's important to check in with someone who can actually give you a physical examination and answer your questions, you know, directly to your face. I'm just providing general information here, and I'm going to actually tailor this response of mine more to situations where the level of prolapse is more mild to moderate and not super, super severe. If your prolapse is to the point where your uterus is actually protruding outside of the vagina, or the bladder has fallen and it's protruding outside of the vaginal opening, then, you know, this is a situation where you're definitely going to want to talk to your healthcare provider. So again, I'm going to speak more to cases of mild to moderate prolapse, and I would say, in my opinion, and based on also opinions and information I've gathered from colleagues, the answer is, first of all, if you want to get pregnant again and it's healthy for your body, then go for it. You know, yes, you can have another baby. The prolapse itself isn't going to prevent you from getting pregnant, okay? So that's hopefully going to put your mind at ease and make you feel better. Also, a lot of people, this is sort of a side note, but kind of related, many people ask, I have prolapse, can I still have sex? Absolutely. there's no reason with prolapse why you can't have sex. It may change the sensation a little bit, but absolutely, there's no reason that you can't have sex or that you can't get pregnant again. Now, what you're really going to want to do, however, is, especially if you are planning another pregnancy and you're in your preconceptual phase, and even in early pregnancy as well, you're going to really want to focus on managing the lifestyle techniques and the lifestyle things you do throughout your day, all day long, that really, really, really add up. Now, as a FemFusion follower and watcher of my videos, you probably already know this information. If you have not already subscribed to my Lift series, it's a free series of videos, I recommend you do so. I will put the link where you can get information about how to sign up for the free PDF handouts that come once a week and the videos. This information in this series provides a lot of detail about lifestyle things. So again, not just exercises, but lifestyle things you do throughout your day, particularly things like posture, body mechanics, correct breathing. So I'll just quickly run over the brief details of some of these things. Posture, you want to make sure that you're not slouching, which is so easy to do when you sit on your nice comfy couch or when you're at work all day and you're typing on your computer and pretty soon you're like this. Just look at all that downward pressure that gets put on your pelvic organs and then your pelvic floor. So right now, again, in the preconceptual phase before you actually get pregnant, or if even if you are pregnant, you want to manage these things. Manage what you can. Maybe you can't reverse the prolapse and get everything completely back to normal, but you can manage where you're at right now. So this is really key. You do what you can with what you have, okay? That's really the key. So the way to manage that, one way is to, you know, have nice tall posture when you're sitting and standing, so you're not putting all that downward pressure like that. When you're standing, again, nice, tall, lifted posture, you want to also be sure, though, that you're not jutting your ribs forward like this, your lower ribs. You want to draw your ribs down just a bit. Certainly not to the opposite extreme where you're like this, but you just want to be in a nice, tall posture. When you jut your ribs forward, that's usually compensating for things like tight shoulders. Because your shoulders are tight, you kind of go like this, which throws your back out of alignment. And also potentially can weaken the anterior abdominal wall because it overstretches these muscles right here. That is not good because we need our whole inner core unit to be able to really work together, fire together, and be strong together as a whole. So that includes your pelvic floor, your deep abs, your back muscles, your breathing diaphragm, everything through this whole center of your body. So again, posture for so many reasons is really important, and it's a controllable. So control the controllables. This is really important. Another one is to manage your weight. Now, this isn't to say that you need to drop a whole ton of weight, especially if you are currently pregnant. You know, you need to be very careful with your weight. I mean, we don't want you going on some kind of crash diet or something like that. Certainly not. However, if you are in the preconceptual phases, if you're thinking about getting pregnant, then now is definitely a good time to make sure that your weight is at a good level, a good healthy weight for your body type. Now, the reason is that prolapse is actually potentially more of an issue for people who are overweight. So this is a time, preconceptual again, a time to think about really cleaning up your diet, drinking plenty of water, ditching the soda pop, cutting out sugar, focusing on amping up your cardio, go on some more walks. Get your heart rate up. I have some fun cardio, low impact cardio videos that are great for people even who have prolapse. So, you know, focus on moving more, eating clean, shining brighter. That's my tagline. Eat clean, move every day, shine brighter. So focus on dropping a little bit of weight in a healthy way. And it's, again, best to do this preconceptually, not when you become pregnant. But this is really important too. So we've talked about posture, we've talked about managing your weight. Another thing is correct breathing. So I talk about this again in depth. The reason we want to breathe correctly, so exhaling with exertion is huge, or exhaling during transitions, such as lying down on your back to sitting up. You want to roll through your side and exhale as you come to a seated position. Even coming from sit to stand, it's a good idea to exhale when you go from sit to stand. If you're lifting something, you want to exhale as you lift. Pushing, pulling, all of that. Anytime there is significant exertion, you want to exhale. When you exhale, it lifts your breathing diaphragm. So right here, it lifts your breathing diaphragm, and your pelvic floor naturally lifts along with it. And then also your deep abdominal muscles, your transversus abdominis, also activates as well. So everything kind of activates and lifts up. Rather than if you grunt it out or just hold your breath, there's going to be a bearing down, and it's going to increase pressure on the pelvic organs and the pelvic floor. And all of that is a recipe for disaster if you have prolapse. And of course, again, this is something that you can at least get in the habit of in this preconceptual phase so that you can continue correct lifting during pregnancy and then, of course, after you have your baby too. So again, controlling the controllables, managing what you're dealing with already, and just really preventing things from getting worse. Another thing is preventing constipation. If you have constipation, then definitely get yourself regular. This is super important. Some women get even more constipated during pregnancy. It's just really important to figure out what your body needs right now. I do have a system for constipation relief, the Smooth Move system that I will put a link to somewhere. It's a great system that you can look into. There's also other things that you can do as well. You can do twisting and stretching videos in the preconceptual phase to help with, you know, wringing out your internal organs. It can help detoxify your body and get your digestion running. You can do hip circles even when you are pregnant. That's a safe exercise even for pregnancy. And that can also be really nice and stimulating for digestion. Drinking plenty of water, eating plenty of fiber, that's really huge too. So things that you wouldn't necessarily think about. But again, manage the things that you can manage. One thing that's a potential for you to consider during the preconceptual phase especially is to use a pessary. And that is a device that you can insert vaginally to help support your pelvic organs. Now, during pregnancy, it's a bit more controversial, and it also may be a bit more uncomfortable because, of course, the growing weight of the baby is making everything kind of shift and change, and it just might be awkward to have the pessary in. It's also potentially controversial in some areas. Physicians will not allow people to wear pessaries during pregnancy because of the thought that it could introduce more bacteria into the vaginal canal because of inserting and then removing the pessary. So it's something to consider there. But particularly in the preconceptual phase, you might consider a pessary to help support the pelvic organs to keep everything in place so that you can strengthen around that pessary and really help to amp up the core strength, core activation before you get pregnant. So I think the next big thing to talk about is actually when you are in labor and when you're giving birth, there is going to be, you're going to have an increased risk potentially for making the prolapse worse if there's a lot of pushing and straining. Now, oftentimes second or third or fourth babies, I only have one, so I can't really speak to this, but I've heard that the, you know, following labors are much, much easier. And this is documented as well. So that being said, it's still, anytime you're giving birth, it's a difficult thing. There's a lot of work to it. This is a big thing. But I guess the great thing is that you'll at least know what to expect after you've already had one baby, so you know what's coming. But I do recommend taking some type of hypnobirthing class. That's just an example, but some kind of class that can really help you learn how to relax and let go. One thing that can actually be helpful is to focus on not just Kegels during pregnancy and contraction and strengthening and tightening exercises essentially for your pelvic floor, but also to focus on reverse Kegels. So you can absolutely do Kegel exercises, pelvic floor exercises during pregnancy for sure, but you also want to focus on, well, let me back up. You always want to focus on the release. A Kegel exercise, really only half of it is the contraction. The other half is the release. But during pregnancy, you really, really super duper want to focus on the release, the letting go, because you're going to have to release. A lot of pregnancy is about surrendering to the natural process of what's happening in your body. You know, you can't help but your abdomen to expand. You can't help but these muscles to stretch. The tissues, the skin, you can't help this. This is going to happen. You can't fight against it. It's natural. It's happening. So don't fight it. Work with it. And again, work with understanding how to release in a safe and controlled manner so that it's going to be that much easier to smoothly release that baby when the time for labor comes and there's not going to be so much pushing and straining. So guys, that's it. That's all I have for you for right now, but I think that the take-home point to kind of wrap it all up and bring this home is that if you have prolapse, first of all, talk to your doctor. Second of all, it's likely, especially, you know, with mild to moderate prolapse, it's likely that there is no problem. Of course, you can get pregnant again if that's what you want and your family design wants to have another baby and it's the right time, then go for it. Don't let prolapse stop you. Now, I do recommend controlling the controllables, managing the things that you can manage. So you're not necessarily going to reverse that prolapse, but you can help prevent it from getting it worse, and you can do whatever you can to manage it during the preconceptual phase and during pregnancy, and then to really focus on, as much as you can, a smooth birth process, again, that relaxation, hypnobirthing, something like that to really help you be able to release so there's not so much excessive straining and pushing during childbirth. Definitely focus on posture, lifting correctly, exhaling with exertion, managing your weight, managing constipation, and I think that's it for now. So thank you for watching. I hope that answered your question. And if there's any other questions, just let me know in the comments. I'm happy to do these videos, these Q&A videos, and we'll tackle them when I can. So I will talk to you all next time. Thank you for being here. And until next time, remember, eat clean, move every day, and you will shine brighter. Bye.